Well, tonight, I want to take us back and inspire us from a place in our childhood that most of us can maybe remember. I remember growing up, I loved doing connect the dot pictures. As you can see here, our team has put together a connect the dot for me to actually experience. And I love these because as a kid, there's just this great anticipation drawing from one line to the next. You start at the number one and you begin to take it down to number two. You bring it up to number three, come down to number four. And it's just like, you just, the adventure of it, not fully knowing like what it was gonna become, but you try to guess and you kind of try to figure it out and you try to assume. But then you get to these moments where as you're kind of drawing, it kind of takes different turns that you didn't expect it to take. And then you start thinking like, wait a minute, maybe it's not anything like how I was assuming it to be. You see, these pictures, they have a creator, an author, someone who has decided what it's to become. And see, it's simply our job to follow. We just follow and connect the dots in order. And as we do, the picture begins to come alive. It begins to take shape. Jeremiah 29:11. It says, "For I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future." Notice who the plans come from and who they belong to. You see, the Bible says God holds his plans for you. And it's a plan to prosper you. It's hopeful. It's made just for you. You see, God has designed a purpose, and then he made you to fit it and to fulfill it. Oh, I hope this promise, it encourages you tonight as we all face a change of our plans. I mean, let's be honest. We all had our plans for March, we had our plans for April, we had our plans for May, and now all of our plans have all just drastically changed. I know couples who've had weddings planned, events, festivals, and all these things, all these plans have been drastically altered. And it's tough. It's confusing. It's not easy to grapple with or fully understand. But we must be reminded tonight that what hasn't changed is God's firm control on our lives and his plan for us. You see, those verses and most of the Bible, actually, it points to this powerful idea that we're really not in control. I mean, control really is an illusion. We can take comfort in feeling in control, but ultimately God is in control. And we're given a choice to trust him, especially in these seasons when things aren't happening the way that we thought. Proverbs 19:21, it says, "You can make many plans. You can fill up your calendar. You can chart out 10 years, and that's not a bad thing. But listen to the end of this verse, but the Lord's purpose will prevail." In other words, you can make plans, and some may happen and some may not, but here's what you can rest assured on. God's purposes always come to pass and prevail. God is never just standing by with his arms crossed, just taken by surprise with the circumstances of your life. He's active right now. He's speaking, he's equipping, and he's changing us as we allow him to. You know, one of my favorite passages in the Bible is Ephesians 3:20. In verse 20, it says, "Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we might ask or imagine according to his power that is at work within us." I mean, think about that. What a statement of faith. What a promise. I mean, when I think about this verse, I mean, it makes me wonder, like, this guy must have been experiencing incredible success. His bank account had to have been overflowing, living lavishly, seeing the dots connect in his calendar and in his five-year plan just as he expected them to. I mean, to write such a statement. But here's the powerful, powerful truth. The Apostle Paul, he's not writing from a place of external comfort, friends. He's not writing from a place of certainty and stability. Paul is writing this from a prison cell, a place that wasn't a part of his plan. He's facing uncertainty, and it looks, on the outside, it looks hopeless. This dot, you could say, was unexpected. This was like a left turn on his plans, and it went way over here. This was just not a part of what he expected. But Paul knows, and he's able to write this promise, that God has a plan, and his purpose always prevails. You see, Paul's peace and hope, they weren't coming from what's happening around him. The writing of this verse is evidence that his peace and his hope were not coming from a location or an external source, but he has learned, friends, to experience the peace of God right in the midst of the problem. Though the location doesn't make sense to him, this wasn't a part of the plan, he trusts God is working. He trusts God's going to connect the dots as he does his part and as he stays in faith. Like Paul, maybe it's in these moments of our lives where we're given the opportunity to really hold loosely our plans and hold tightly to God's promise. Hold tightly to his peace, discovering that hope comes when we trust his plan. Let me encourage you tonight. Don't let your peace be dictated by your plan. Let your peace come from the presence of God in your life. The peace of God, it's not the absence of problems. It's actually the awareness of his presence and his plan for your life. I bet many of you, you can look back on your life, you can look back on the course of your life and see that God has brought you through some crazy circumstances and moments of uncertainty. I mean, as I look at this, I see this zigzagging all over the place. Things take a turn away from your plan, away from what you thought was going to happen. That reroute, the layoff, the hurt. In it all, if I just choose one chapter or one line on how it went way left or way right or way up or way down, if I just take one period of the journey, it's hard really to understand, why is this happening? Why am I going way over here? Why am I going up here? Why did this happen? Why did this injury take place? Why did this thing happen with my job? Why did I experience this loss, this setback? But when I take a step back, and I look at the picture now, and I begin to see from a different perspective, I can see how each step actually connected to the next and began to form something absolutely incredible. You see, I can see that certain connections connected me to the right person at the right time. Certain connections develop certain character qualities in my life. And these certain connections were necessary in his plan to make me into what he wants. Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. It says, trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Do not depend on your own understanding. Seek his will in all you do, and he will show you which path to take. So let's fully lean into the grace that's been given us for this dot, this chapter, this season of our lives. Let's make the most of it and not worry about tomorrow and what we can't control. Use the grace for today. Trust God's plan. Lean into it and embrace the people that God has put in your life at this moment. And so when I look at this picture, I can see that there's a great plan. There's a great purpose. I can finish it off. And when I step back and I see from a different vantage point, I can see that things were working together to form a bigger picture, an important picture. And friends, at the end of your journey, because you've walked in faith and you've fixed your eyes on Jesus and you've anchored in peace and you've trusted him, you can see it all come together as well. Romans 8:28, it says, "For God works all things out for good for those who are in Christ Jesus." It all works together in his hands because it's his plan. It works together for our good. It works together for others' good. And it works together for his glory. Wherever you're at tonight, trust God. Believe he's in control of your life and he's doing a deep work. Let me pray for you. Father, I thank you for your grace right now. I thank you, Jesus, that in times of uncertainty, we can trust you and we can know that you hold the plan for our life. And even when our life takes turns of uncertainty, even when things happen that we didn't expect, we can trust that you are the architect of our faith and you're the architect of our life, that you created a purpose and you created us to fill it. And so we stand and choose tonight to rest in faith, to embrace your peace, knowing that we don't have to have everything figured out, knowing that we don't have to see our problems even go away to experience this peace, but we can receive your peace right now, even as we're watching, even as we're listening. We can experience your presence and rest in it and find strength in it. So Father, we release control to you and we say, have your way in our lives. We know you're going to give us grace for today, grace to manage what we need to manage with our relationships. You're going to give us grace to flourish in our jobs. You're going to meet all of our needs according to your riches and glory. Oh, we embrace your grace today. In this dot, you could say, of our lives, knowing that you're going to connect us where we need to go, and knowing that you are orchestrating and putting together a bigger picture, a bigger plan for our lives. So we love you and we thank you. And in this moment of worship, we say, continue to speak to us as we declare our faith in your promises. We love you. In Jesus' name, amen.